I recently got asked a question on the Trulift Digital channel for a video that I did on how to choose a hosting plan with HostGator, where the viewer was a bit confused on exactly what he would be paying for and when. He didn't feel comfortable spending too much money now and wasn't clear on what he would pay for immediately versus monthly. Essentially, how does HostGator pricing and billing work? HostGator pricing, if you are new to it, can be a bit confusing. So in this video, I'm going to show you how HostGator pricing works, as well as a few things to be aware of when you are purchasing your hosting plan from HostGator, and then I'm going to share with you a coupon code for HostGator so that you get the best possible deal when you purchase your hosting. Let's roll the intro. Hey guys, Kevin at Trulift Digital Marketing, where we help entrepreneurs and small business owners help others through their products and services using digital marketing. So like I said in the intro, we're going to focus in this video specifically on HostGator pricing. So if you wanted to find out more information on choosing a hosting plan with HostGator, I've already created a video to that, which I'll link to in the cards above and also down below in the description area called Choosing a Hosting Plan with HostGator. But in this video, let's jump on my computer and get started. Okay, so we're going to start off on this page here. And to get to this page, just pause this video and scroll down below the video. And in the video description, you'll find a link to the specific page. But you're also going to find a HostGator coupon code that we're going to talk about more specifically in the rest of this video. Now, before we even get started, I want to disclose that I am an affiliate for HostGator, which means that in the event that you use either my coupon code or the link to get to this page and you ultimately purchase your hosting through HostGator, I will receive a small commission from them. Now, that's not going to cost you any more. In fact, I'm actually going to show you how using my link can actually save you some money. And I'm also going to show you where it might not make sense to use that HostGator coupon code at all. It might be cheaper possibly to not use it. Now, I think most affiliates would tell you to use their coupon code no matter what. But what we're after in this video, of course, is just to get you the best deal. So if you do like this video and you want to support this channel and the free content that we host here, obviously I would appreciate it if you would use my link and coupon code, but there's obviously no obligation to do so. So in this video, we're not going to deal with anything else other than the pricing related to web hosting. So you can either click on the Get Started button below or the web hosting here. So I'm just going to click on that. And that's going to take you to this page here. You'll notice at the top that there's a free domain name that you can get if you sign up for 1 year of hosting. I'm not going to talk about any of that specifically in this video. I've got other videos where I discuss the fact that I don't actually use the same domain name registrar as I do hosting company. If you want to find out more information on that, you can check out those other videos. But for the purpose of this video, I'm also not going to talk about the specific plans because, like I said, I've got a link to that as well. So the plan that I use is actually the baby plan, which right now you'll notice has a 60% off rate. So there's some additional savings there. Now that might not be available. That changes from the time of year, and I'll discuss that a little bit further as we get into the video. But the plan that I always use is the baby plan, just because it has unlimited domains. And even though you think you're probably not going to use more than one domain, I've always found that I end up using more than one. So that's the plan that I use. But of course, you can choose whichever one that you want. But for the purpose of the video, let's use the baby plan and just click on the Buy Now button. And that's going to take us here, and the filling out the form is somewhat self-explanatory, so I'm not going to go over that as well. If you already have a domain name, you click on this tab and enter your domain name here, or you can buy your domain name through HostGator if that's what you choose to do. But the area that I wanted to focus on is in this Choose a Hosting Plan section, and specifically this section here for billing cycle. Now, when that person asked that question on my YouTube channel, they were confused about the pricing and how it works, so I just wanted to clear that up hopefully in this video. So in that person's specific scenario, they basically wanted to try and lock in some of these larger discounts that are available from 12 months and on, 12 months, 24 months, and 36 months, but they didn't want to come up with a large sum of money now. They just were a little bit tight on cash. So let's just use the 12-month scenario just for the example purposes. They wanted to know, okay, if I sign up for 12 months at $5.95, does that mean I'm committing to 12 months right now, but I will be paying $5.95 per month for the next 12 months? The answer to that is no. And that's where the confusion lies. What you are doing essentially is whatever billing cycle you have in terms of term, the length of time, whether it's a month, 12 months, 24 or 36, whatever you agree to for time-wise on the billing cycle, that is what you pay for today. So in that 12-month scenario, essentially it's 12 months at the equivalent of $5.95 per month. That's what the math would work out to with the 50.21% discount. But you're paying 12 times $5.95 per month today. Okay, so not over 12 months, but actually all up front today. So 12 times roughly 6,
$72 would be payable today when you give your credit card and you basically you go through the checkout. Same thing with 24 months, you would pay 24 times 495 today, 36 times 395 today. Okay, so that's not spread over that period of time. That's what it works out to on a monthly basis, but you pay for it all right now. So just like pretty much any retailer, what they're effectively doing is they're trying to incentivize you to lock in for a longer period right now as opposed to going month to month. Now, so you have to basically ask yourself the question, I mean, what works best for you right now? Are you super tight on cash? Would it make more sense just to go on a month-to-month basis and pay $11.95? You're going to forego, obviously, the savings that come with locking for a longer period. But the trade-off, of course, is that you don't have to pay for basically prepay for that amount up front. Or do you want to lock in that savings? You're okay. You know you're going to have your website and your hosting for a long period of time. You've rather get the opportunity to share in that discount, and so you're going to lock in for a longer period. That's really just a question that you have to answer for yourself. Now, I do want to point out one thing, though. If you're thinking perhaps, oh, well, you know what? Maybe this discount's going to go on for a little while, or maybe I can use Kevin's link sometime down the road. What I'm going to do is just lock in for a month now, or maybe a shorter period of time. And when I do have some more cash, maybe in a month or two, I'm just going to come back and try to get those discounts. Unfortunately, they've closed that loophole. So I'm just going to direct you to this page here, where it says coupon codes are valid for new signups only, not valid for any pre-existing packages, products, services, or renewals. So unfortunately, they've kind of got that covered off there. It only applies these discounts only apply if you're basically new to HostGator. Let me show you how this works and how you can get basically the best price on your hosting. Now, for example purposes, let's just assume you're interested in the 12-month period and getting a 50.21% discount. And if you're interested in the shorter period of time, the 1 month, 3 month, or 6 month, also stick with me to the end of this video because I'm going to show you actually how you can save a bit more money for those periods as well. But for the purposes here, let's just click on this 12 months, and then I'm just going to scroll. Basically, you would fill in your username and PIN. You would fill in this information and billing, your credit card, and so forth. But I'm just going to scroll down to the bottom and show you basically what your price is, what you would be paying for today. Now, it's showing you a total of $127.09. The reason for that is you're getting your discount here on your hosting, but what they're doing is they're adding add-ons here, hosting add-ons. So let's just scroll up a little bit. What you'll notice is HostGator basically already pre-selected two specific add-ons for you. This site backup for $2 a month, basically, and this site lock essentials for another $1.99 a month or billed annually. So they obviously feel that those are important, and they are. So I'm not trying to dissuade you in any sense from getting those two things or from unchecking them. And for that matter, there's other options here that you can also check. You do get a bit of a discount. It's not the full discount, but I think it's like a 10% discount. I'll show you just a second when we scroll down. But essentially, I'm going to uncheck these just for the purpose of this video because I already have site backup that I use, a free WordPress plugin to back up my website. And as far as hackers and so forth, there are other free resources that you can use. For example, I use Cloudflare. To basically prevent from hackers and so forth. But again, I want to be very clear that I'm not dissuading you from these things. Anything that basically helps you out or keeps you more secure, I'm all in favor of. But for the purpose of this video, at least, I'm going to uncheck those. And then we're just going to scroll to the bottom and see what kind of effect that has on your price. Okay, so if you remember before, we were at $127.09 when we had those add-ons added, and now we're back down to essentially $76.11. So you're $72 more or less, plus your estimated tax. Okay, I just want to direct your attention up to the top here where it says enter a coupon code. Now, if you came through my link, or perhaps even if you didn't, you would see a pre-populated coupon code here of shared 3660. Now, if you didn't come through my link, it depends. HostGator has different discounts throughout the year, so that your discount might not be as high as it is kind of currently stated here. But if you did come through my link, in all likelihood, you're going to see the shared 3660. Now, I gave you another coupon code in the description area, so I just want to plug that in and show you what happens there. That one's Web Presence 60. And so if I type that, before I hit validate, just take note of the amount due. It says 76.11. If I hit validate, it actually went up in price, so $91.72. So here's a particular instance where using the coupon code that I gave you, the web presence 60, actually for basically 12 months, 24 months, and 36 months, isn't going to actually save you anymore. You're better off to just keep the existing coupon code if, in fact, that shared 3660 was pre-populated in there for you. And again, I can't say whether it will or not. But let's scroll up to the top because I want to show you, now that I've got that coupon code entered, I want to show you what the various prices are with that coupon code. Okay, so here's a breakdown basically with the Web Presence 60. And then I'm just going to switch to a separate page here. And now you can see that actually for 12 months, 24 months, and 36 months, Web Presence 60 only gets you a discount of 50 and 60% off respectively, whereas the shared 3660 gets you 50.21, 54.79, and a little bit higher of 60.3 for the 36-month scenario. So in instances like this, where it's 12, 24, and 36, you're actually better off not to go with Web Presence 60. And if you have the opportunity of having shared 3660 actually be able to validate as a coupon code on your page, then obviously you're better off to use that. But if you look here for the scenario with 1 month, 3 months, and 6 months for Web Presence 60, you're actually a little bit further ahead with a 20% discount for those three respective periods if you use Web Presence 60. By testing out both HostGator coupons, the default shared 3660 and my Web Presence 60 coupon code, you'll find the best coupon code for HostGator for you. Now, I just want to quickly talk about HostGator renewal pricing and how you can save even a little bit more money. So if I was to click on this 12-month period right here, you can see that basically it's going to run for one more year. And then at the end of that year, you're going to be charged $11.95 per month. Okay, so basically regular price. But if you sign up for 24 months, it's going to run for 2 years basically, but your renewal price is going to be based on $10.95 per month for the entire 2 years at the time of renewal. Okay, and then also the same thing with 36 months. It's going to be down, instead of $11.95, it's down to $9.95. So you're going to save the equivalent of $2 per month for the 3 year period that's due on the renewal date. Now, another thing that I want to mention is that unless you cancel, and to cancel, basically you have to fill out a cancellation form and then speak to a live support agent. So make sure you follow kind of the proper protocol there, but you will automatically be renewed at the expiry of your plan and for the same billing cycle that you originally signed up for. So for example, if you signed up for 12 months, at the end of 12 months, it's going to assume that it's going to automatically renew you for 12 months. At the end of 24 months, of course, it's going to do the same thing. It's going to renew you for a 24-month period. And 36 months, of course, it's going to renew you for 36. Now, you don't have to stay with that if you don't want to. You can drop down to month. So say, for example, you're on a 12-month plan, you've gone your 12 months, and you don't want to sign up for another 12 months or basically prepay for the next 12 months. You want to drop down to month. You just have to let HostGator know that ahead of time. And from a personal experience, I would just say the easiest way to do that is probably give them at least 30 days notice. It's just going to make the transition a lot smoother in your billing. Another thing that I should point out is they do have a 45-day money-back guarantee. So if you sign up for any one of these plans, as long as you're inside that 45 days, just simply let them know. There's a protocol to do that, but just click on a link. There's probably one at the bottom of the screen in terms of how to cancel. You just basically cancel it and you'll get your money back. And then once you've nailed down the coupon code for HostGator that you're going to use and what respective period that you're happy with, basically just fill out the rest of the information, scroll to the bottom, choose whatever options you want, and then just simply click on the checkout now. And that's it.
So there you have it. In this video, we discussed how the HostGator pricing works, as well as I provided you with a coupon code for HostGator that you can use to get the best possible price when you do purchase your hosting. If you enjoyed this video, we'd really appreciate it if you'd hit that like button. It really does help a channel like this out quite a bit. And if you're interested in more videos like this, feel free to subscribe and also hit the bell notification icon to be notified of new videos as they come out. And if you're interested in checking out that video on choosing a hosting plan with HostGator, I'll link to it at the end of this video and in the description area. Until next time, take care of yourself and your loved ones.